not there, I think. Okay, now. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Today in this class, we are going to start with the next concept, which is there in the module one, that is, that is aggregates. Okay, na? So this subject, concrete technology, in the first module, we are discussing the ingredients, cement, aggregate, water. These are the basic aggregate. Apart from that, we have admixture. In the admixture, you have chemical admixture and you have mineral admixture. Okay, na? In the first part, in the last five classes or so, we have discussed cement, no? In the cement, we have discussed the manufacturing of cement. Okay, wet process, dry process, we have studied. Okay, na? And manufacturing, after that, we have seen the properties. Okay, na? We have after discussed the test on cement, whether these things are completed for from your side.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I request everyone to reply. Okay, every time I will not tell. It's each and every person's responsibility to say something in terms of response. Okay, na? I request everyone. Everyone. Okay. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
On the screen, whatever is written, is it visible clearly?
Yes, sir.
Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Is it visible?
Visible. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. In this chapter, we are going to discuss the aggregates. Why aggregates are important? What are the types of aggregates? What are the properties of aggregates? What are the tests on aggregates we are going to see? Now, if you construct any building masonry work, only cement and only water, what is going to be problem? What is there to be problem? Can anyone tell? If only cement and water, because cement is a binding material, water will react and it will make a paste which will bind. Now, if you don't use aggregate, what type of problem you are going to face, I will tell. Only cement, if you are using, it will lead to shrinkage, first problem. Second problem, first is the shrinkage problem. Second is what? Costly. It will become more and more costly. Okay. For 1 cubic meter of some masonry work, if you put only cement and water, it will become more costly because cement itself is costly. Other than that, you can go for adding aggregates. If you add aggregates, which will combine with cement water, forms one dense mass, which is also good for binding, which is also good for load carrying. Then it will be economical. Yes or no? It will be economical. Second point, it will reduce the shrinkage. It will reduce the shrinkage. Okay, na? So in the aggregate, you have majorly two parts. One is fine aggregate, another is coarse aggregate. See here, cement particle will combine with fine aggregates and make one mortar, and this mortar is pasted around the, is occupying around the bigger aggregates, so that one complete dense mass will be prepared. One complete dense mass will be prepared. Okay, now, whatever thing you take, no. So to increase the density of a given mix, you want to add aggregate, increase the density. To increase the durability also, you want to add the aggregate. To reduce the shrinkage, to give a proper shape, and it will be economy. Okay, na? First foremost point is, it will give bulkage to the concrete. It will give bulkage to the concrete. Okay, na? A fine aggregate, the sand portion, will assist the cement paste to hold the coarse aggregate in suspension. I just now told, no, cement is there. It will combine with sand and make one paste, and this paste will be applied to all over the bigger aggregates, so that it will give one good body. It will give one good body. And also, it will stop the segregation. What do you mean by segregation? Separation of a bigger particle and smaller particles separately, then it will call it as segregation, which is a bad product for concrete, which is a bad product for concrete. So this is about introduction part of the aggregate. What are the functions of aggregates in mortar and in concrete? In mortar, only cement and sand will be there. in concrete, cement, sand, and coarse aggregate will be there. Sand is nothing but fine aggregate. Cement, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate will be there. First portion, the aggregate which is giving is bulkage. Bulkage means what? For a given quantity of aggregate, the volume is increased. For a given quantity of aggregate, cement, sand, the volume is going to increase. That is called as bulk. That is called as bulk. Okay, now setting, it will help in setting of the cement, setting of the concrete. Third is, it will reduce the shrinkage. It will reduce the shrinkage. Shrinkage is reduction in volume. Shrinkage is reduction in volume. Fourth function is, it is going to give the strength. It is going to give the strength. What are the functions of aggregates now? Bulk, setting, shrinkage, strength. These are the four major important. And also, it will give more surface area for cement to act. It will give more surface area for cement to act such that a thin film is formed around all the aggregate and which will be interlocking or binding with one another. Binding with one another. What are the requirements now? How the aggregates should be? That is one important concept. They should be chemically inert. Means what? They should not react with one another. It should be clean. The aggregates should be sharp, angular, and durable. And it should not contain any salts. And it should be well graded. What do you mean by well graded? For a given sample, if all sizes of aggregates are present, bigger, medium size, smaller size, so that wide content is less and filled content is more. Well graded means particles of bigger size, medium size, small size. If almost all particles are present, then we call it as well graded. And in well graded, the voids are less, filled material is more. Okay, na? So generally, aggregates constitutes 75% of the concrete. The remaining will be cement and water. Up to 75% is more. Okay, na? So whatever aggregates you want to take, no, they should be clean, hard, strong, and well-graded. Very, very important. Clean, hard, strong, and well-graded. Now, this is what classification. We have so many classification depending upon size, shape, strength, all these parameters are classification terminologies. Okay, now. So now aggregates can be classified as normal weight, light weight, heavy weight. Yes or no? Can be classified? No. Normal weight means whatever we generally use for building construction. Light weight means what? Whenever you want to construct something, roof, some partition wall, which should be very, very light. Heavy weight aggregate means what? For foundation of bridge, for foundation of road work, where you require. My voice is audible for everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, we were discussing normal weight, light weight, and heavy weight. Okay, na? So normal weight are generally normally used. Light weight for roofing material, partition walls. Okay, na? Heavy weight are used for bridge piers, foundation work. Also, we can classify it as natural aggregates, artificial aggregates. Natural means what? From river, if you are getting, from natural earth you are getting, those are called as natural aggregates such as sand, river sand. Okay, na? Artificial means what? From crusher, from furnaces, the slag, the bolted clay, all these are what? Artificial. Okay. Source means what? You have seen the geological classification. Yes or no? Geological classification, igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, metamorphic rocks. Igneous rocks are what? Rocks formed by cooling of lava, molten lava. If you get the rocks from this, these are very, very strong. These are very, very crystalline in structure. Very strong, very durable. Okay. Almost all building material aggregates are taken from igneous rocks. Sedimentary means what? The erosion will take place. of igneous rocks, water, wind will carry the particles of igneous rocks, deposit somewhere else, so that layer type of structure will be formed. So that layer type of structure will be formed. So these are not good in load carrying. These are not good in load carrying. Only a covering can be used. So sedimentary rocks are not much of a use. Only one or two rocks are generally used. What do you mean by metamorphic? If these two rocks, igneous and sedimentary rocks, are taken under the action of heat and pressure, if their heat and pressure is applied, some chemical rearrangement of particles will take place. Chemical or internal structural change will take place, and a new type of rocks will be formed. Those are called as metamorphic rock. Generally, metamorphic rocks are not good in load taking. They are not good in strength characteristics. Only they are used for architectural purpose, aesthetic purpose. Architectural or aesthetic. Is this point clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So, what is what we are discussing? Almost all rocks we are generally using from igneous rocks. Almost all the rocks we are using from igneous rocks. They have high percentage of silica. They have high percentage of silica. Sedimentary rocks, generally, they are soft. Generally, I am telling generally. Some rocks may be hard, but some generally they are soft, they are porous, they are light in weight. Why? Because they are in layer type of structure. They are in layer type of structure. They are not used as strength carrying aggregates. They are used just to cover something, cover the something. The last one, what is that? Metamorphic is not at all suitable as a aggregate for strength or load carrying, only used for architectural purpose. Some rocks are quartzite gneiss. Quartzite and gneiss are the some metamorphic rocks. Okay, na? According to size, how many classification we can do generally? Fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. Correct, na? Generally, less than 4.75, fine aggregate. More than 4.75, coarse aggregate. Apart from that, we can also tell that it is silt, fine sand, medium sand, coarse sand. Okay, na? Normal aggregate, heavy aggregate, big aggregates. Last one is boulders. Last one is boulders. Like this also we can classify. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
All persons, why you people simply sitting there? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Gantesh, Harish, Utesh. Please reply. Baba, reply. This is class. Okay, na? Okay. Now, what is the advantage of using bigger size aggregate? What is the advantage? Okay, na? If you want to do the concrete of some foundation work, you can also use a small aggregates. You can also use medium size aggregate, and you can also use bigger aggregates. Some advantage of bigger aggregate is that it will reduce the cement consumption, it will reduce the water consumption, it will greatly reduce the shrinkage. It will greatly reduce the shrinkage. These are some of the advantages. But using of bigger aggregate has some limitation. If this member itself is 10 mm, like a thin partition wall, you cannot use 20 mm aggregates, correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. If in a given beam, given column, if reinforcement spacing itself is 10 mm, you cannot use bigger aggregates, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes,
if the
sir,
reinforcement
sir.
Spacing is 10 mm, you cannot use 20 mm aggregate, because aggregates will not go and correctly fill all the spaces. Third point. If the cover itself is 10 mm, that means the reinforcement bar to this exterior surface, if the cover is 10 mm, you cannot use bigger aggregates, correct?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
And also, yes, if sir. Your equipment which is used for mixing and placing is not suitable for big aggregate mixing, big aggregate transportation, then you cannot use bigger aggregates. So these are some of the limitations. What are the limitations? Thickness of the section, cover, spacing, mixing and position. Depending upon these conditions, you can use the maximum aggregate. You can use the maximum size of aggregate. Without steel, for rubble soling, you can use up to 160 mm. But for RCC concrete, normally we use what is the mm? what is the mm?
20 mm.
20 mm aggregates we generally use. 20 mm and downsize. 20 mm and downsize. Downsize means lesser than 20. Okay, na? So fine end cores we have just now studied. And how the classification is done depending upon the shape. How the classification is done from the river, if you take the aggregates, they are more or less rounded, more or less rounded, smooth texture, smooth shape, perfect round. Due to continuous water movement, continuous water erosion, the particles are becoming round and round, more round. But the if you take the aggregates from crusher, these are not round, correct na? Aggregates from the crusher, if you take, they are irregular shape and rough texture. These are called as rough, or you can say angular aggregates. You'll get what? Angular aggregates. See here, rounded aggregates from river bed will give good workability but less bonding. These things will give good workability and less bonding. Angular aggregates will give good bonding but less workability. Good bonding but less workability. What do you mean by workability? How easily you can mix, place, compact, transport. All the things we call it as workability. How easily we can do the concreting. How easily we can do the concreting. Now, so that is called as workability. Or just now by seeing the diagram only you can understand, no? Rounded bonding is good or angular bonding is good? Can anyone tell me? Kajal Pawar? Irshad? Which one is good?
Angular, sir.
Angular gives bonding.
Angular.
Angular gives. Manoj Gowdar, which one will give good workability? Murgesh Teggi, which one will give good workability? Angular or this one?
Angular aggregate.
Angular. Now, Murgesh, you tell me, which aggregate will consume more cement? Angular or smooth aggregate?
Smooth aggregate.
No. Rough textured or angular aggregates will require more cement. Why? Because its surface is like this, no? Smooth or rounded aggregate will require less cement to cover, but angular aggregates will require more cement to cover. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Correct. Murgesh?
Yes, sir.
Try to understand the concepts. Okay, na? So like this, you have so many types. Shape. Flat aggregates are good. Elongated aggregates are good. Or both are bad. You tell me. Flat, flaky, elongated aggregates are good or bad for a concrete? Prajwal Bagli Kote?
Bad,
sir. Bad, sir.
Very bad. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Okay, na? So like this, you can have so many classifications. Can you see in this diagram? These are called as rounded. These are called as flaky or flat or elongated. The last one is what? Can anyone tell me the last one?
Angular.
Angular
or normal?
Which we have taken from the course. So, crusher. So, these things are good in bonding, good in strength, good in interlocking, but poor in workability. You cannot easily mix and compact. But these things are good in mixing, placing, transporting in concrete, but bonding is less. Bonding is less. Okay. These things will require less cement, less water. These things will require more cement and more water. The between these things, the middle types, which are not at all used or should not be used in concrete. This is clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, there is one test, we call it as shape test. We call it as a shape test. In the shape test, we are going to find out the angularity number. Angularity number means, suppose if this we are taking aggregate, for this is a rounded aggregate. Generally, when you conduct the test, these aggregates will give more angularity number. These aggregates will give you less angularity number. Angularity number is nothing but one parameter. How angular are the aggregates? How angular? If the angular number is more, that means aggregates are angular. If the angular number is less, then its aggregates are smooth and rounded. Now, suppose there is a container. Suppose this is a 100 ml container, 100 ml container, and you put aggregates, like this, any aggregates, you fill it completely, tamping rod, everything you completely filled, okay, na? Still voids will be less, na? Still voids are there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what you do, you put water so that it will completely filled to the top level. Suppose 100 ml is the capacity. After putting the aggregates and compacted in a proper way, you put the water. Water required to, which is fill the top level, suppose it is coming out to be 30 ml. Now you tell me, what was the void content? What was the volume of voids which were present in a given sample? Mansi madam?
Yes, sir.
How much is the void content? Volume of voids. I hope you have not understood. Suppose in a given container, after putting the aggregates, you slowly fill the water to the top level and you require 30 ml of water to fill it to the top level in an aggregate placed container. What was the void? Void volume is equal to void volume of water only, because this 30 ml is filled where? Is taken where?
Is filled in the voids.
So whatever water you have used, no, that much water is nothing but void content. If the void content is more, that means it requires more water. Correct? It requires more water. Now you tell me, in rounded aggregates, the voids are more, or in angular aggregates, the voids are more?
In rounded aggregates.
No. Rounded aggregates, voids will be less. In angular aggregates, the voids will be more, because these are angular, which will not get compacted fully. These are not get compacted fully. That is why voids will be more in angular aggregates. That is why it requires more cement paste than rounded aggregates. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Everyone understood this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is angularity number in an experiment? Suppose, let us take a container, you put the aggregates, you put the water. Now, water volume, if it comes to be 33%, if water percentage is coming out to be 33%, to fill the voids, then angularity number is called as zero. That means aggregates are perfectly round. Voids are very, very less. Less means minimum void is 33. Beneath this, you cannot go. Beneath 33%, you cannot go. So that is why angularity number for this perfectly round aggregates, which have very, very less void, you take zero as the angularity number. Suppose if you take some angular aggregates, some normal angular aggregates, you put it there. Suppose water consumption is 35%. Then angularity number is 33, 34, 35. Two is the angularity number. Suppose if you take a container, so for the same experiment, if you put a very angular aggregates, very angular in nature, so that void content is more, so that volume of water required to fill, that is 44%, then angularity number will be how much?
11.
44 minus 33 is 11. So minimum angularity number is 0, maximum angularity number is 11. So depending upon the situation, you go for a perfect aggregate for the use. Perfect aggregate for the use. This is called as shape test. This is called as shape test. Yes or no? These are poorly shaped crushed aggregates. Flaky, elongated will come. Here, these are perfectly cubical aggregates, which are very good for strength giving. These are angular aggregates. These are cubical. These are angular. These are good aggregate. Good aggregate. Okay, na? So like this, you have to, depending upon the condition, you can go. Can you see here 40 mm size? You can have rounded, you can have irregular, you can have angular aggregates. So depending upon the requirement, you can go for rounded, angular. If you want more strength, more bonding, you go for angular. If you want very good workability, such as a slab concreting, you go for rounded aggregates. Like this, you have to decide depending upon the situation. Angular aggregates always use good bonding, good interlocking, good strength, but cement consumption is more, void content is more, okay, workability is less. Opposite of that one is rounded aggregate, good workability, less cement paste consumption, okay, less water content consumption, okay, na? But bonding is also less, bonding is also less. So depending upon the situation, you have to use. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay, yes, another sir. Shape test, another shape test. Have I not, I have already explained na, this one, this part.
Yes, sir.
Everyone, this test, everyone is aware?
Yes.
So many students are
yes, aware.
I need yes, an
sir.
Answer from all the persons.
Yes, sir.
Do, everyone yes, is knowing sir. This test?
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Everyone know this test, elongation index? So, yes, please tell me clearly, no problem.
Yes, sir.
These two tests.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Nandita, Nihal, Prajwal, Sahil, yes, Shruti. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
These two tests. You can, okay. Texture. Texture is what? Outside surface. Outside surface. Smooth texture, rough texture. Smooth means what? It is fully polished. It is fully polished, such as the river sand. Rough textured means what? Angular aggregates which are taken from crusher. Now you tell me which case good bonding is there? Smooth texture or rough
texture? Rough texture.
Very good. Cement consumption will be in which case it is more?
Rough texture.
Rough texture.
Good interlocking in which case it is more?
Rough texture.
Rough texture.
Water consumption in which case it is less?
Smooth.
Smooth texture.
Water consumption in which case it is less? Water consumption.
Smooth.
Smooth textured water cement smooth. Consumption is less. Okay, na? So like this, you can, depending upon the texture also, you can have so many. How you can measure the texture? They have given some simple methods. By using the magnifying glass, by using the electrical or optical instrument, okay, na? By using with the magnified image. Other than that, you can also have indirect method, such as dispersion of light method. Okay, na? So if the dispersion is at some angle on an aggregate, you can call it as smooth. If the dispersion is in haphazardal manner, then you can call it as rough texture. Apart from that, there is one powder test. What is that powder test? On a surface of an aggregate, if you put some small powder and if you rub it on the surface to cover a given aggregate surface, if the powder, that fine powder consumption is more, then it is a smooth or rough texture. If that aggregate contains more dots or more rough structure or more scratches on the body, then fine powder consumption to cover that surface is more or less?
More.
Okay. That is also a test. We can use it for rough texture and smooth texture. Okay, na? Okay. Strength. How to conduct the strength? Very, very important test. Okay. For slab concrete, for foundation concrete, for column concrete, you always test the aggregates for their strength. You always test. Okay, na? How the tests are generally conducted? Okay. Why the tests are required? Whenever you want high strength concrete, ultra high strength concrete, whenever you have a doubt on aggregates, whether these aggregates are good or bad, whether you want to check for industrial process, whether you want to check the aggregates are good or bad from pressure, that time you can go for aggregate testing for strength. Whether this test is there, have you know this test? Aggregate crushing, aggregate impact, loss.
Impact test.
Yes or no?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. Now see here, just I will tell how to conduct this strength test. One first test is aggregate crushing value. What you are doing, you are taking the sample which is passing 12 mm, which is retaining on 10 mm. Okay, na? 12 mm passing, 10 mm retaining, you are taking the aggregates and you are putting it. You are putting it in a measuring cylinder. You are putting it in a measuring cylinder. Take the weight of aggregate, W. Okay, na? And you take one into the crushing machine, UTM machine. There you apply the load slowly increasing. Slowly increasing load you apply so that aggregates are crushed. Aggregates are crushed. Now you take out the aggregates and pass it through 2.36 sieves. Pass it to 2.36 sieve. Now what is happening there? If aggregates are poor, aggregates are weak, then you find a quantity which is more passing. Correct? If the aggregates are strong, then the passing fine powder is less. Passing fine powder is less. That means less powder formed during crusher. That means aggregates are strong. More powder. That means passing through 2.36 mm sieve is more than aggregates are what?
Weak, sir.
Weak. Very good. This is the aggregate. Limitation. Limit is 30%. You can have maximum 30% is the aggregate value. So fine powder divided by original weight into 100 is nothing but your aggregate crushing value. Is nothing but your aggregate crushing value. Similarly, if you apply a load impact, that means you have a hammer which is falling on this sample. In the first case, we have applied load slowly, gradually increase the load intensity. But in this case, suddenly you are applying, that means using the hammer, you are making the aggregates to crushed. Aggregate to crush. So that means it is called as impact test. And the procedure is same. 12 mm passing, 10 mm retained. You take the aggregate in this bowl, okay, na? This bowl, and measure the aggregates W1 before the experiment, and you apply the impact load. So many blows you are going to give, and you take that one again. Use 2.36 sieve to get the powder quantity. If the powder quantity is more, that means aggregates are
weak.
Weak. Simple as it is. Okay, the aggregate impact value is also same thing. Fine powder after the experiment to the original weight into 100 is what aggregate impact value. Aggregate impact value for good weights, good strong works, you need require stronger aggregates. Means what? Aggregate impact value should be less or more?
More, sir.
I'm telling. Aggregate impact value should be less or should be more? You tell me, for a good concrete. Aggregate impact value, aggregate crushing value, Los Angeles abrasion value, whether these values should be more or should be less for good concrete?
More. Less, sir.
It should be less. It should be less. Why? Because formula is what? Fine powder divided by original weight into 100. Na? So if your fine powder is more, then your value will be more. If fine powder is less, then your value will be less. Then in which case powder will be less? Stronger aggregates, no? So lesser AIV or lesser ACV or lesser abrasion value, the stronger will be the aggregates. So that is why they have given the limits of 30%. You cannot go more than 30%. That means what? 30% fine powder is forming under the impact load. Here, what is happening in abrasion? You are taking the aggregate and you are putting it in this jar, in this rotating drum, and also you have some steel balls. You have also steel balls, and you give rotation. You give rotation. Under the rotation force, the aggregates will collide with the steel balls, so that abrasion is generated and aggregates will be broken down. Again, you take the fine powder quantity, measure that fine powder and divide it by the original weight into 100. So this value, we call it as what value, Murgesh Tegim? What is that experiment and what is that value called as? Akash, what is that value? Which experiment? Amrit Mane, what is experiment?
Abrasion test, sir. Abrasion value.
Very good. Los Angeles abrasion value. This term we call it as Los Angeles abrasion value. In all the three experiments, you are taking the fine powder under the various loads and you are taking the ratio with the original weight of aggregate. So multiply by 100 will give some percentage. Those are called as values. Always remember, these values should be less as far as possible. As far as possible. Okay. Now, modulus of elasticity is that one parameter. How modulus of elasticity is impacting? What do you mean by modulus of elasticity? Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity? Stronger aggregates will have its modulus elasticity more. Weaker aggregates will have their modulus of elasticity less. That means the stress by or not? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Can I? Stress by strain is nothing but modulus of elasticity. More stress, yes, but less strain, nothing but good aggregates. Less stress, but more strain means more deformation. That means they are poor aggregates. That means they are poor aggregates. Okay, na? So like that you need to understand. Everyone has done bulk density test.
Yes,
have you done? So many people.
Yes, sir.
Abu Bakar, yes. Akash, Bartha.
Yes, sir.
Bulk density, yes, test. Now, what is the implication? If the density is more, that means aggregates are good or bad? You have to tell me. If the density or bulk density, whatever density is more, that means aggregates are good or not good?
Bad.
Gomtesh, sir. Kapana.
Sir.
Lakshmi. ಮನೋಜ್ ಗೌಡರ್ ಕೆಂಪಣ್ಣ, ನೀನು ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡಪ್ಪ, ನಿಂದ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬೆನ್ಸ್ ಬರತೈತಿ, ನೀ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ. ಮನೋಜ್ ಗೌಡರ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಪ್ಪ ಆನ್ಸರ್? ಅಲ್ಲೋ, ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ಸ್ ಚಲೋ ಇರ್ತಾವ. ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಯಾವಾಗ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬರ್ತೈತಿ? ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ಸ್ ಫುಲ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಇದ್ದಾಗ. ಹೌದಿಲ್ಲೋ, ರೇಟ್ ಚಲೋ ಬರ್ತೈತಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಅದಾವ ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. If the aggregates are strong or full, that means your density is more, that means aggregates are strong. In reverse case, if aggregates are porous, like this, if they contain pores, so that air is there, other things are there, then means its density will be less, na? If voids are there, in the pores are there in their body of aggregate, that means aggregates are light in weight, that means density is less. Porous aggregates are good or solid aggregates are good?
Solid ones are good, sir.
Pardon? I have not clearly or see, listen to you.
The solid ones are good.
Solid ones are good. That means if the density, if the density is more, that means aggregates are good. Whether my voice is clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now next is the specific gravity. Has everyone conducted this test? Specific gravity.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. What is the range of?
Yes, sir.
What is the range of aggregates specific gravity in your lab?
2.6 to 2.8.
About 2.8.
About 2.8 or below 2.8?
Below
2.8. 2.6 to 2.8 is the normal aggregate specific gravity. Okay, na? If the specific gravity is more, whether it is good or bad? ಎಲ್ಲ ಉಲ್ಟಾನೇ ಹೇಳ್ತಿರಲ್ಲೋ. ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟಿ ಯಾವಾಗ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬರ್ತೈತಿ, ಯಾವಾಗ ನಿಮ್ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ ಅವಾಗ ನಿಮ್ದ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದ. ಯಾವಾಗ ನಿಮ್ದು ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ಸ್ ಪೋರಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ, ವೀಕ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ, ಫಾಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ, ಫ್ರಾಕ್ಚರ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ, ಅವಾಗ ನಿಮ್ದ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿನು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಬರ್ತದ ಮತ್ತ ನಿಮ್ನು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಬರ್ತದ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟಿ. Not good. You cannot say bad aggregate. Not good or not quality aggregate has lesser specific gravity. Is that okay, everyone? Try to interact. Wow. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Everyone. Gayatri madam.
Yes, sir.
Gayatri madam, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋದ್ರಪ್ಪ? ಕೇಳಾತದ ಇಲ್ಲ? ನೀವು ಮತ್ತೆ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕ್ರಿ, ಸುಮ್ ಕುಮರಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಅಭಿಷೇಕ, ಅಬೂಬಕರ, ಆದರ್ಶ, ಏನಪ್ಪ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಕುಂದಿರ್ತಿರಲ್ಲ, ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ. ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಹಾ, ಆದರ್ಶ, ನೀವು ಇದನ್ನ ಮಾಡಿರೇನಪ್ಪ, ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್, ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರಿ. ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಹೇಳಿ, ಸುಸು ಹೇಳಿ ಮಾಡಿರಿ. Okay, this is the diagram. Voids are present in the body. On the surface, it is there like this. Fully water means what? Saturated. But on the surface, it is dry. In this case, water is present inside the body as well as on the surface. These are called as moist aggregates. Air dry means what? Only inside little bit water is present, but on the surface as well as little body, that is not at all water. So those are called as air dry. So how many categories of aggregates are there depending upon the moisture content?
Four.
Bone dry, air dry, just saturated and fully moist. Okay, na? Just saturated are generally good for concrete. Just saturated or air dry aggregates are good. This is also not good. This is also not good. Why? This will absorb the water which is there to cement hydration, and you will have less water for cement hydration, so that cement hydration is not 100%, so that no bonding, so that concrete is poor in this case. In this case, more water is available for hydration, more water there in concrete, so that segregation will form, bleeding will form, pores will form, capillary pores, capillary cavities, voids will form. So this will also not good. Only this and this are okay. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Bulking of aggregates, how many have you done? This experiment everyone has done or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You have to tell me now, bulking. What you are actually finding there? You are adding water to the normal sand, no? So there, how much increase in volume that you are measuring? That is called as bulking.
Bulking.
Huh. fine aggregate bulking is more or coarse aggregates bulking is more? Lakshmi, Mangoli?
Fine aggregates
bulking is more. Why? Because more surface area, more repulsive force will be there. So that is why bulking is there. Okay, na? So this formula everyone remembers, no? How many of you got this experiment in your main exam?
Me, sir.
Who? Yar bandittu adu? ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿರಿ ನೀವು ಹೇಳ್ರಿ? ಓವನ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಜನರಲಿ ಯು ಯೂಸ್ ಓವನ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಆರ್ ಓವನ್ ಮೆಥಡ್, ಓಕೆನಾ? ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ಲಿನೆಸ್, ವೆದರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಡರ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲೇ ಫಾರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಬಾಂಡಿಂಗ್.
Yes, sir.
Now, there is one more concept, soundness of aggregate. What do you mean by soundness? Soundness in the cement case, what we have understood in the previous chapter, when that magnesium or lime which is present inside the cement, it will not react with water in the starting phase. Okay, it will react after 1 month. So that means bulging will take place. So bulging of cement or concrete after setting is called as unsound, is called as unsound, unsound. Sound aggregates or sound cement or sound concrete means it is not going to bulge. Now you tell me, aggregates should be sound aggregates or unsound aggregates? You tell me.
They should be sound aggregates.
They should not show any bulging. That is the important parameter. Okay, na? Everyone understood?
Yes.
Okay. Next is alkali aggregate reaction. What do you mean by alkali aggregate reaction? The name itself tells.
Alkali
is a chemical which is present in cement. Aggregate is nothing but aggregate. If alkali is present in cement, which will react with the reactive aggregate, they form one gel, which is called as alkali silica gel. We call it as alkali silica gel, which is not good, which is very, very bad. Alkali silica gel is not good, very, very bad, because it has got very bulging property. Which has got very, very bulging. 220% increase in volume you will get. That is good or bad for concrete after setting? If it
bad,
bulges,
sir.
Very bad. So that type of reaction you should understand. Okay, na? So how to avoid that one? Select the cement which is less alkali. Select the aggregates which is less reactive. Two major causes, two major preventive measures. Select the cement which has less alkali compounds. Select the aggregate which are less reactive. And also it will depend upon moisture, and also it will depend upon temperature. Control the moisture, control the temperature, control the cement, control the aggregate. So you can easily control the alkali silica reaction. So now here you can see, this is an aggregate. This is a cement paste. Okay, na? This is the reactive aggregate. This is the reactive alkali cement. So when they combine, no, this gel will form. This gel will form. It is slowly, it will bulge. And concrete will make rupture. So can you see the cracks here on the aggregate silica gel formation? Can you see the cracks here?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, how to control? Good cement with low alkali, good aggregates which are not reactive, using pozzolana, using good control in space in concrete, control the temperature and moisture. It can easily control the aggregates. Okay, no? Other property, which are just supplementary property, what are those? Thermal property, coefficient of expansion, specific heat, thermal conductivity. When these things will come into picture, when you have a big project like a dam project, dam body, dam wall, dam foundation, road, there all these property of aggregates will come into picture. Why? Mass concrete works will have highest temperature. High temperature rise inside the body. So that time aggregates should be less coefficient of expansion, less specific heat, less thermal conductivity. That time you can use this one. Yes or no? Normal value is 9.9 into 10 to the power minus 6. You should not necessary to remember this one. Just try to understand these terminologies. Okay. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. What do you mean by grading? If all the particles are present, bigger, medium, smaller, then that is called as well graded or poorly graded?
Well graded.
It is called as well graded. Grading is nothing but separating the different size of particles. Grading is nothing but presence of different types of aggregate sizes. That is called as grading. Well grading means all particle sizes are present so that voids are less. So that cement consumption is less. So that water consumption is less. So that means it is a well graded, which is good for concrete. Which is good for concrete. If only one type of aggregates is used, or only some type of aggregates are used, if it has more voids, then it is called as poorly graded. Then it is called as what graded?
Poorly graded.
Poorly graded, which will consume more cement paste to fill the voids, which will have more voids, which will go porous, which will go as a porous. Now you tell me, which aggregates are good now? Manjunath, yav aggregate chulapa? Manjunath? So, Nakshatra madam, which type of aggregates you prefer, the concrete? Okay, she is not there. Kajal Pawar, which type of aggregates are good? Well graded or poorly graded?
Well graded, sir.
Well graded. Why?
It avoids voids.
Yes. Correct. It avoids voids. It has less voids. Cement consumption is less. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Very good. Okay, now. So that is called as grading of aggregate. What is the test? You tell me. Which test you do it for particle size distribution?
Sieve analysis.
Everyone, very good. Sieve analysis is the experiment to conduct the particle size distribution. Have you done this experiment?
Yes, sir.
Everyone.
Yes, sir.
By the sieve analysis, you can do easily particles. What parameter you generally find? Prajwal Bagalkote?
Fineness modulus.
Fineness modulus you will get. Okay, na? So that experiment you already know. Okay, na? Yes. So there is no need to worry. Okay. This is not this one, specific surface and surface index. This is not okay, not necessary. Okay. What is standard grading curve? What is there in the x-axis? This diagram, grading of aggregate, we are discussing now. What is there in the x-axis?
Sieve size.
Sieve size. What is there in the y axis?
Sieve size.
Percentage passing.
Percentage passing. Okay, this is the graph after sieve analysis. Okay, na? Let us see. Let us take this curve. Curve number four. Suppose if you take 20 mm sieve. In this fourth sample, how much passing? How much material is passing?
100%.
100%. Yes or no? Now, for the same sieve, for the sample one, how much percentage is passing through that 20 mm sieve?
100%.
That is also 100%. Very good. Now, come to this sieve. What is that sieve? 4.75 sieve. For the sample 4, how much material is passing through this 4.75 sieve?
50%.
How much percentage? 50%.
50%.
For the 4.75 sieve, how much is the percentage passing?
30%.
How much is passing?
30.
Only 30 is passing means, which is coarser, sample 1 or sample 4?
Sample 1.
Sample 1 is coarser sand or coarser aggregate. Because less material is passing, sample 4 is finer sand or finer aggregate because it is passing more. Now you have understood the graph? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
These are the standard curves. These are called as standard curves. For different works, the engineer will tell, I need zone C sand. I need zone B sand. I need zone A sand. Okay. So what is zone C? If the sample in your site, if it falls here, if your graph, if it comes like this in between, then what type of zone it is?
Zone 3.
Zone C, you should say C. C is the zone. 4, 3, 2, 1 are the standard curves. Okay, na? Standard curves. If your sand like this, while doing the experiment, if your sand is coming like this, then your curve will be site curve. The red curves are standard, already obtained. But when you are doing the experiment in your site, your experiment wheel is giving a graph like this. Then it is lying between 2 and 3. Which zone it is going to come?
Zone B.
Engineer will tell, we require zone C sand, zone B sand like this, he is going to tell. For slab concrete, he will go for coarser. For plastering and all, he will go for finer, like that. Okay? Like that, you have to understand. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, like that. So this, I think we have already explained. Okay? Whether this is already explained, yes or no, try to recall this point. I have already explained this one. Yes or no? Zone 1 is coarser. Zone 4 is finer. How? If you take this sieve, okay, na? So how much percentage passing? 90 to 100. But here it is 95 to 100. But, okay. But when you take 1.18, zone 2 has how much percentage?
55 to 90.
Zone 4 is how much? 90 to 100. Now which 200. Is fine? Which is fine?
Zone 4
is the fine. You people are very intelligent, Baba. I know. See how easily you are understanding. Very in one explanation, you people are understanding. I'm very, very happy. Okay. Nihal, Manjunath, everyone, Kajal, Gayatri, Hari, Shidesh. Are very intelligent people. Okay. Have you take generally Complan or Horlicks or Bormita? Which drink you take, sir? All people?
Sir, tea.
Tea. By, don't lie, Baba. Sul helabadri, correct helabadri. Yen tontiri, Horlicks or Complan, yen tontiri?
Sir, tea.
Sul helabadri. Nan gotta the new junior Horlicks tontiri. How did you?
Sir, na senior, sir.
Senior. Alala. Junior to untiro, senior to untiro, yen to untiro, nimga gotta. ಬಟ್ ಶಾಣ್ಯಾರ ಅಂಕಿ ಅದ್ರಿ. ಏನ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಬಾಳ ತಿನ್ನತ್ರೇನ ಆಪ್ಲ ಬಹುತ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಕರ ನೇಹಲ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಬಹುತ್ ಕಾರ ಹೇ ಕ್ಯಾ ಬಾದಾಮ್ ಕಾಜು ಗಿಜು ಬಹುತ್ ಕಾರ ಹೇ ಬಹುತ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್
ನಹೀಂ ಸರ್
ಫಿರ್ ಇತ್ನಾ ಹೋಶಿಯಾರ್ ಕೈಸೆ ಬಾಬಾ ತುಮ ಲೋಗ ಪಹಲೆ ಸೇ ಹೇ ಕ್ಯಾ ಹಾಂ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ಹುಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಯು ಪೀಪಲ್
ಯಾರ್ ಥಾ ಸರ್ ಇಸ್ಲಿ ಬೋಲ್ ದಿಯೆ
ಓಕೆ 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 ಅನುಶ್ರೀ ಮೇಡಮ್ ತಿಳಿತಿಲ್ರಿ ಅನುಶ್ರೀ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಹೋದ್ರಪ್ಪ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋದ್ರು ಬಸವರಾಜ್ ಹನಗಂದಿ ಬಸವರಾಜ್ ಅವರ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಹೆಣರಿದ್ರಪ್ಪ ನೀವು ಎಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿದೆ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ನ ಒಟ್ಟ ಹೇಳಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಆದ್ರೆ ಬಹಳ ಹೇಳ್ತಿರಪ್ಪ ನೀವು ಓಕೆ ಕ್ರಶ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ ನೀವು ಹೇಳ್ರಿ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ರಶ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಎಂ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಗೋ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಜನರಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ವೈ ಯು ಯೂಸ್ ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ಮಿ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಮಿ
ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟರಿಂಗ್
ಓಕೆ ವೆನ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಶಾರ್ಟೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಶಾರ್ಟೇಜ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಯು ಜನರಲಿ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ರಶ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ ಸೊ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ಲಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ರಿವರ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನೋ ರಿವರ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಓಕೆ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ವೇ ಯು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೇಕ್ ಆಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಆಸ್ ಕ್ರಶರ್ಸ್ such as crushers and manufacturers okay depending upon the crusher quality depending upon the crusher quality you may get angular you may get medium you may get cubical older aggregates old type of crushers will give you very bad type of this one okay na but the new type of crushers modern crushers they will give very good cubical or very good angular aggregates this is called as a cone crusher this is called as cone crusher somehow visible this diagram whether this yes, is sir. visible
sir.
Ah, okay yes, no, sir. see can you see yes, so aggregates will be poured from this top or boulders or rocks from the crusher okay na so here you get me get the crushed aggregates you get crushed aggregates. What is gap breeding very important concept see here container if you put all the 40 aggregates all the 40 aggregates you will get larger voids correct larger voids only one aggregate size if you are using larger voids suppose 40 plus 20 40 plus 20 then you can call it as medium voids then you can call it as medium voids 40 plus 20 plus 10 then it is called as very very less voids because voids of 40 will be filled by 20 voids of 20 filled by 10 so like this the voids of bigger aggregates are filled by smaller aggregates now in gap grading in this type of if all the particles are present then it is called as well graded that is one thing gap graded means they are using 40 which is highest aggregate and they are using 4.75 they are not using intermediate aggregate sizes why they don't require whatever the voids are present of 40 they can directly filled by 4.75 that is called as gap grading means what some sizes are absent only bigger and voids which are filled by the smaller particles in between range of size is absent but still you will get very less void high density this type of concept is called as what
gap grading
so here to fill the voids of 40 mm you are using 4.75 aggregates you are not using 10 mm you are not using 20 mm similarly when the bigger aggregate sizes you take 20 then to fill the voids you go for 1.18 you take 1.18 okay na so what is the advantage of gap grading sand consumption is less more specific area less cement consumption good bonding between all the aggregates is it clear for everyone
yes sir
yes sir
okay.
yes sir
ah Gayatri madam, can you tell me the advantages of gap grading? Can you tell me the advantages of gap grading?
Sand consumption is less, sir.
Hmm.
Good bonding.
Hmm. ಮತ್ತ ಎರಡ ನಾ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಕೇಳಿದೆ ಎಸ್ ಸರ್ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಆಯ್ತು ಅನುಶ್ರೀ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ ನೀವು ಆದರ್ಶ್ ಹೇಳಪ್ಪ ವೈ What are the advantages of gap grading? Adarsh? Akash, I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me what are the advantages?
Less water requirement, sir.
Very good. For gap grading, you require less water.
Less cement consumption.
Less cement consumption. Good. Very good. Yes, sir. Recycled aggregate. Can anyone tell me what do you mean by recycled aggregate? I will just tell. If there is a building or if there is a road which is not used or which is already damaged, what you do, you excavate that building, you dismantle the its slab, its column, its footing, you take the road, you excavate everything, and this material which is excavated or which is taken out from already constructed building or already constructed structure, that material is broken down using crushers. That material is broken down using crusher, and that crushed material will act as aggregate in new concrete works. The broken material from the crusher, from the existing or old building or old work, that crushed material is used as aggregate in the new work, and then aggregates are called as what aggregate? What aggregates?
Recycled aggregate.
Very good. What is that process? Breaking the old concrete, crushing, removing the impurities, again you are taking the grades, and last one, separating the coarse and fine. So this is about recycled aggregates. What are the important property here? Because already it has got cement on the surface, no? Already some cement will be added on the aggregates, no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That is what water requirement is more here. For recycled aggregate, water requirement is more. Okay, na? Absorption value is more here. Absorption value is more. Okay, na? Yes. Okay. So another important thing is that when you're taking that old building, you may get unwanted material such as wood, timber, pieces of glass. All those things should be separated. Then only those materials are used as aggregates. Other than that, you cannot use. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What do you mean by marine dredged aggregates? Marine dredged aggregates means you have taken that aggregates from the seashore or seabed. What is the problem with that one? It will contain salts. It will contain salts. Once the salts are present in your aggregate, it will consume water. It will consume water for what? Cement. From cement water that mix is there, no? It will take water. So reaction will not take place, or incomplete reaction will take place. So that means no bonding or less bonding is taken. Okay. So that is the problem with the marine dredged aggregates. Only these aggregates can be used as a filler material or subbase works. Means what? Above this, again, good aggregates are placing. These are used in road works. Road works, not in top, not in middle layer, only at the bottom layer, which is used as a fillers, which are used as a filler aggregates. So marine dredged aggregates are used as a filler aggregates, filling works, not generally used for concrete works. If you want to use for concrete work, you should wash it thoroughly so that salts are completely removed. Salts are completely removed. Yes? What is the water? next is water. Okay, na? Water is very, very important. Water is very, very important. What are the requirements of water which is used for concreting works? Can you tell me? What are the requirements? Arud. ನೀರ್ ಹೆಂಗಿರ್ಬೇಕಪ್ಪ ನಾವು ಸಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಕಾಂಕ್ರೀಟ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಕತ್ತೇವ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀರ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ತರ್ತೀರಿ ನೀವು ನದಿ ಒಳಗಿನ ತರ್ತೀಯೋ ಸಮುದ್ರದಾಗಿನ ತರ್ತೀಯೋ ಬೋರ್ ನೀರ್ ತರ್ತೀಯೋ ನಳದ ನೀರ್ ಹಾಕ್ತೀಯೋ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕರ್ ಹಾಕ್ತೀಯೋ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಹಾಕ್ತೀನಿ ಆರುಡ್ ಎಸ್ಕೇಪ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇರ್ಷಾದ್ ಇರ್ಷಾದ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಓಕೆ Same question is for Prajwal, sir.
Sir.
ಏನ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ
ಹೇಳ್ರಿ ಸರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್
ನೋಡ ಈಗ ನಾವು ಕಾಂಕ್ರೀಟ್ ನೀರ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಮಾಡೇವಪ್ಪ ನಾವು ಈಗ ಏನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡತ್ತೀವಿ ವಿ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ದ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಒಂದು ನೀರ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಪ್ಪ ನಾವು ಕಾಂಕ್ರೀಟ್ ಗೆ ನೀರ್ ಎಂತದ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ ಚಲೋ ಎಂತದ್ ಹಾಕಬಾರ್ದ ಸಮುದ್ರದ ನೀರ್ ಚಲೋನು ನದಿ ನೀರ್ ಚಲೋನು ಬೋರ್ ನೀರ್ ಚಲೋನು ನಳದ ನೀರ್ ಚಲೋನು ಎದ್ರ ನೀರ್ ಚಲೋ
ನಳದ ನೀರ್ ಚಲೋ ಸರ್ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಇರ್ಬಾರ್ದು
ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಇರ್ಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಫ್ರೀ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಇಂಪ್ಯೂರಿಟೀಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಆಲ್ಕಲಿ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ ಎಕ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ ಓಕೆನಾ ಜನರಲಿ ಪೋರ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ವಾಟರ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಮಿಕ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಓಕೆನಾ ಸೀ ವಾಟರ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ನೆವರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ 6 ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ 6 ಇಫ್ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ 6 ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಸಿಡಿಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಸಿಡಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಂಕ್ರೀಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಕೊರೋಜನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆಸಿಡಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಂಕ್ರೀಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ ವಿತ್ corrosion that is very very important okay na these are the requirements so this is some table is given you can just refer okay na? This is just refer only one thing is that okay
yes sir
any doubts in this one whatever we have discussed any doubts
no sir
please feel free ellarigu kelri abubakar akash arun helra paya
no sir
No, sir. No doubt, sir.
Bharata, Basavraj.
No doubt, sir.
No doubt? Okay. Ee idan chemical admixture start madona?
Sir, I...
Sir, bad.
Yes, bad.
Yeah, correct.
Bad, sir. Bad, sir.
Head, head. Bare dena head. Niva head. Saak, eh?
Haan, sir. Saak, sir.
Yes, sir.
ಶ್ರುತಿ ನಾಯಕ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಶ್ರುತಿ ನಾಯಕ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ವೆದರ್ ವಿ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಆರ್ ವೆದರ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಶ್ರುತಿ ಮೇಡಮ್
ಎಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ವಿಶ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ಬಾಡಪ್ಪ
ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಿಶ್ ಟು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಯು
ವೆದರ್ ಓಕೆ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸೀ ಓಕೆ ಸಾಹಿಲ್ ಕಲಂಗುಡ್ಕರ್
Yes, sir.
ಏನಾರ ಹೇಳು
ವಾಟ್ ಸರ್
ಕ್ಯಾ ಕರೆಂಗೆ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಕರೆಂಗೆ ಯಾ ಛೋಡೆಂಗೆ
ಥೋಡಿ ದೇರ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಕರೆಂಗೆ
ಥೋಡಿ ದೇರ್ ಕರೆಂಗೆ ಕಾಜಲ್ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಸಾಕು ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಬಲ್ಲ ಕೇಳಬಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಹೇಳತ್ತಿದ್ದ ನಾಟ್ ಆಡಿಯಬಲ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಕೇಳಬಲ್ಲ ಗಾಯತ್ರಿ ಮೇಡಮ್ ನಂಗೇನು ಕೇಳಬಲ್ಲ ಟೈಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಹಾ ಎಲ್ಲಾರು ಚಾಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ದಾಗ ನಿಮ್ ಯು ಎಸ್ ಎನ್ ಹೆಸರು ಬರೀರಪ್ಪ ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಚಾಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ನ ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ ಎಲ್ಲಾರು ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಚಾಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗ ಯು ಎಸ್ ಎನ್ ಮತ್ತ ಹೆಸರು ಎರಡು ಬರಿಬೇಕು ಯು ಎಸ್ ಎನ್ ಮತ್ತ ಹೆಸರು ಎರಡು ಬರಿಬೇಕು ಇದ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟ್ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಬರೀತಾರ ನೋಡಪ್ಪ ಜನ. ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಗೆ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಹೇಳಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಇದನ್ನಾದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಎಷ್ಟು
ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್
ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್
ಏನತ್ತೆ
ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್
ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡೋರು ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ ಇದು ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು ಮತ್ತೆ ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಮಾಡೋ ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ನಾಳೆಗೆ ಸೇಮ್ ಟೈಮಿಂದ 4 to 6 ಓಕೆನಾ, ನಾಳೆಗೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡೋಣಂತ. ಬೇರೆ ಏನಾರು ಇದ್ರೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಪ್ಪ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹಂಗೆ ಏನಾರು ಬೇರೆ ವಿಚಾರ ಇದ್ರೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ, ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಟಿಲ್ ನೌ? ಸಿಮೆಂಟ್, ವಾಟರ್, ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಮಾನ್ಸಿ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಎನಿ ಡೌಟ್ಸ್?
ನೋ ಸರ್.
100% ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್?
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಆಯ್ತು, ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್. ಇಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗಪ್ಪ, ಮತ್ತ್ ನಮ್ ಹೀರೋ ಹೀರೋಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಇದಾರೆ, ಒಬ್ರು ಹೀರೋಗಳು ಕಾಣವಲ್ರ. ನಿಖಿಲ್, ನಿಖಿಲ್ ಕಟ್ಟಿಮನಿ, ಏನು ಏನಾರ ಹೇಳಪ್ಪ.